this quarterback now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's 1st and 10. And Jackson throwing once more. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll get nothing out of that one. No gain on the play there. It'll be 2nd down.
Usually the offense has an answer to anything a defense throws at them, including a safety valve. And that's what they did on that play. They went there, but the defense still made an excellent play and held them to no gain.
Again, Jackson. And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack. Back at the 47-yard line, Khalil Mack in there to get him. The 6th time they've sacked him tonight. The Jaguars on 3rd down. They've converted a 1/3 of their opportunities, 3 for 9. This will be 3rd and forever.
Here we go now. Green 39. Green 39.
From the gun, Jackson. Now he's going to send this one deep right center. This is caught inside the 15. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a 1st down with a nice throw.
Stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's 2nd and goal. Going to get it running right. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on 3rd and goal. So stuff for no gain on 2nd down brings up a pretty interesting 3rd from this distance.
I'm throwing the ball, and I'm not even thinking about play pass. I'm going to let them know right away I'm throwing it. I'm probably giving my quarterback some room, sprint him out to one side or the other, and give him an opportunity. If it breaks down, he can take off and run for it.
He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's 4th. And before this 4th and 3 play, we're going to get whistles and a timeout. It's just their 1st. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the 4th quarter. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This for a 4th quarter lead. And Gano's kick is right through. And with that, they have taken the lead by a point here in the 4th. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
After knocking through the field goal, here's Gano back out there now for the kickoff. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
And Brandon, you know that expression? He just does what he does. It sounds trite, doesn't it? But in this case, it's perfectly apt. This is one of the better runners in the NFL. And all he does is just find avenues, find ways to pick up key first downs and big runs.
And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Detroit! Detroit!
To throw on second down, Freeman. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and that's going to bring up a third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
On third down, Freeman escaping the pressure right. Now he's going to throw. It's caught inside the 25. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Give him 35 yards there on the third down conversion. They'll run it now out of the gun. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through it. Gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Right back to him on first down. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Time for a break. We're back to perhaps crown a champion after this. They'll run it now out of the gun. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Back-to-back stops make it third and 10. The Packers on third down. They've converted three times and eight chances. This is third and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So on comes the kicker, Dustin Hopkins, in a big spot. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. Now it's scooped up, and this is a live football. And they're going to come up empty here on fourth down.
One universal in football, when it's a kicking situation, all right, you're kicking a field goal, an extra point, you're punting, you never want to hear a second thud. That means the block has occurred. Imagine being the guys on the bench right now, the defensive unit. They thought they were going to get a cushion when they went back out on the field. That's no longer there.
They had the chance to take a second half lead, but the special teams unit, they said, not on our watch. And despite the late lead, Jackson to throw, eluding the pressure right. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. A big pickup there, and without question, that should be more than enough to wrap this one up. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They'll try and chew some clock with Gurley. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And it'll bring up a second and 13. And they take a knee. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock.
I don't know why we did it, but we went to their final walkthrough for some reason. And what did we see? Their last play in the walkthrough was taking a knee and celebrating winning a Super Bowl. They want that visualization. They did it for real.
Yeah, they just scripted it out. Defense can't stop the clock, and they can watch the final seconds tick. And the Jaguars send out their punter as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. And a nice job here to down this one right on the 5-yard line. And the Jaguars have done it. Jacksonville, the Super Bowl champions. For the victors getting to hoist that Lombardi trophy, you know, we've talked to guys that have and they end this year just how everybody wants to end the year, holding the Lombardi Trophy. What a season for them. What a ride it's been for us as well here in the booth. For Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. Thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next season right here on EA Sports.